Hi everyone, this is a quick tutorial showing you how to really make some interesting lighting effects in After Effects. This is not going to be too complex. It's really just about how do you make a grid or a 3D map or something like that look a little bit more interesting than just this plain flat imagery. So what you do, just like you would in Photoshop or something like that, is to add a light. So what I'm going to do here is go to Layer, New, and Light. I'm going to leave it as white and a spotlight, and of course you can change that if you choose to. You can choose whether or not you want to make it cast shadows. I'm going to leave this unchecked for now because I want to show you that this is one of the common problems when people work with After Effects, that they forget that you can cast shadows. So I'm going to click on OK here, and the light is usually centered. If you're in a different view, so for instance, let's say in custom view, and you've rotated this around, then it might be difficult to really see what you're doing here. So I'm going to go ahead and change it to my active camera. And you can see that there are these three little arrows here. There's a blue one, there's a green one, and there is a red one. The red one is the x-axis. You can see there's a little x there next to my mouse. The green is the y, and the blue is the z. And then there's this target, which allows you to choose where you want it to point. So I'm going to first move my x-axis, so it's over here, and I'm going to move my y-axis to move it up, and I'm going to pull my z-axis back to give it a little more depth and move my target. So it gives me a nice angle, really kind of at a 45 degree. So if this was an interview, you'd have a person sitting here in front of a green screen or something like that. And that really gives you a kind of consistent look in terms of your lighting. You can see there's a bunch of things that are done here. The light is on this background, so it's giving a beautiful gradient here, and it's also on both grids. It's important to recognize that you can change that if you choose to. But the first thing I'm going to do here is alter my light. And because I didn't check in my when I first started the light that it cast shadows, it has those shadows as off. I always want to make sure to turn the shadows on if I wanted to end up casting shadows somewhere. And you'll see why I do that in a second. You can actually see down here that there are shadows being cast by this grid. You can also choose your diffusion. So I can say that I want the shadow to be a little bit lighter. So let's say I want it to be at 50%, and I want it to be a little blurred, so maybe at 20 or something like that. And you can see it's much fainter, so it looks three-dimensional, but it's not quite so jarring. This is often really important, especially with a grid like this. So when I look at my horizontal grid, you can see that it already casts shadows. And when I go into material options, which only appears if it's a three-dimensional layer, so you must make it a three-dimensional layer. If I change my material options, I can see that I can turn off whether or not it casts a shadow. So I'm going to leave that on. I can also choose whether or not it accepts shadows, and whether or not it accepts light. So if I turn this off, you can see it becomes bright white again. I actually like to leave this on. I think it's a really pretty nice gradient here, and makes everything look very three-dimensional, which is really what I'm looking for. Don't really worry about the other options for now. You want to do the same for the vertical grid. So my material options, I'm going to leave it as casting shadows on, accepting shadows on, and accepting lights on. If I turn off the accepting lights, that gives me a very clear grid, which is often very useful, but I really want to have the elegance of this diffusion. Now, you might ask yourself, why can't I actually see a shadow here? If I zoom in 100%, you can see the green, and you can see this grid, but you can also see that there are no shadows. The horizontal has shadows, but not the vertical. And the reason for that is that just like having one piece of paper on top of another piece of paper, you can't cast a shadow if it's right on top of one another. And that's because of this green solid. So if I open this, I'm going to check my material options, and you can see that it doesn't cast shadows, but it does accept shadows, which is very important. And then all I need to do is transform where it is in depth, in space. So I'm going to take my z-axis here, and I can either type something in or click and drag. You can see on the mouse it has the little back and forth icon. So I'm going to move that back in space to maybe 11, 12, 15. I'm also going to change this to half because it's just processing too slow for me right now. And that's a very good trick, that if it's processing slowly and you don't care if it looks perfect, then you can change it to half or even a quarter to make it faster. But you can see that if I want to increase this a little bit, I have a little bit more depth here. You can see it more if I go to full. You can see that these shadows will really pop. And of course, if you change your diffusion, Or if you change the depth of the strength of the shadows, then you'll actually see a big change here. But when I go into fit my window here, you really see how much depth is gained. If I go to my custom view and then click on my camera or press C, then you can see how much of a difference that makes. I'm going to go to half to speed it up, and I'm going to go to, let's say, 50% to zoom in. You can see how much depth you gain on the edges here by making this shadow work. So I'm going to go back to my active camera and go to fit, and that is how you make a really pretty three-dimensional image from two-dimensional materials. Good luck.